An emissary is defined as a representative empowered to act independently in conveying information, someone who can cross territories, establish relationship, and tell precious secrets. 10 years ago, at the beginning of an amazing garden internship, I met my emissary. On a foggy morning, a patch of magenta lamb's quarters sparkled like nothing I had ever seen. Each plant holding a single perfect drop of water between its top four leaves. I was completely taken. Every year since then, I have sent it out as a scout, a bright envoy contained in tiny black seeds, sneaking it into every garden I tend to show me the subtleties of the ground and season and bring back delicious secrets. First, it is a harbinger of spring. In that fickle season here, I know I can begin planting when I see that pink and green pop out like so many sparks of a lit fire in the soil. It often comes up in dense swaths, claiming good ground before more problematic weeds can take hold and acting as a living mulch. As it grows and branches, I keep it as an overstory, providing a little cover for crops like cabbage and arugula, so when our cold spring turns so abruptly to hot summer, those plants have a tempered microclimate and are less likely to bolt. I can also sow it as an understory with tall crops like corn, again saving me weeding until the corn provides its own canopy. Then I pull the magenta lamb's quarters, eat some, and lay the rest at the feet of the corn as a green manure. In the meantime, the jeweled carpet of it under the dappled light of corn is amazing. Magenta spreen, as it is called in Europe, is delicious for a long time. First as a fresh green in salads, then the branches and leaves lightly cooked like chard. And even in high summer, the outer stems are still tender and reminiscent of asparagus. It is rich in flavor and very nutritious. In the fall, the whole plant turns vibrant, unpredictable colors, sets hundreds of seeds for the birds and next year's garden, when I'll again find it sprawling into pathways, marking hidden trails of wind and water. Botanically, magenta spreen is a member of the quinopod family, which contains beets and quinoa. And some of them, like auric and amaranth, are excellent self-sowers and cooperative growers, preferring fertile soil and skirting that feral edge without being invasive. It is a great lead for me to follow in the garden, and this edge is a very interesting place. Ecologically, an edge can be rich in biodiversity, where forest meets meadow, water meets land, wild meets cultivated. It is the between, the interplay, a place of changing definition, challenge, and delightful complexity. Magenta lamb's quarters lives here, and being food, ornamental, and weedish all at once, it is an edge itself. So most interesting is how it has revealed the hidden edges in the people in the garden. Their reaction to a cusp plant lacking easy definition is often very telling. It asks, what do they value most about food? And what do they expect of it? How do they define beauty? How important is the element of control in understanding either? What do they see in a garden? And how do they engage with the inevitable wild behavior that happens there? It may take a few years for someone to understand the diligence required to grow food in Montana before seeing the magenta spreen in their garden in a new light. Then I'll tell them it's a superfood, which they love, and it is. And the next time I see them, they can't wait to tell me all the ways they've eaten it. The people who are curious about it or like it right away, I pretty much love them right away. Admittedly, it is a bellwether for my own feral heart. And best of all, magenta spreen has revealed to me the soul of cultivation itself, which by its nature is the shared territory of coevolution, a place where in tending, one is tended in return. At its heart, agriculture is not just about measurable productivity. I am here to tell you, It is all about immeasurable connectivity, a matrix of cycles and relationships regenerating each other. Seeing 10 pollinators on my favorite flower that I planted, a harvest overwhelming enough to require help and real generosity, and in turn providing plenty for everyone. Seeds passed hand to hand and coated with the memory of storm and drought, dormancy and unique climate. How many ways and how creatively we can nourish each other and the whole biotic community that holds us. From this perspective of exquisite diplomacy, large-scale industrialized monoculture looks to me like war, where almost all attributes of soil, plants, and bugs, and people, and the connections between them are marginalized into only what can be commodified, and the edge is an oblivion of diminishing returns. I love cultivating the myriad and small, because the intricacies have brought me to my knees in awe, kept me happy and sane. I believe we need beauty, nourishment, and community to be intertwined a million times more than we need cheap food. And it's actually not that hard. It's as easy as getting your hands dirty and following your own nature down a winding path. And if you would like some Magenta Lamb's Quarter seed, I have some to share. Thank you.